welcome everyone. Would you please now stand as the bride makes her entrance? Celebration of the miracle of love. Eric and Laura, today in the presence of God and these witnesses, we celebrate this miracle in your lives. In Mark 10, it says, "But God made them both male and female from the beginning of creation. This explains why a man leaves his father and mother and a woman leaves her home, and the two are to be united as one. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?"
Her mother and I.
Would you please join hands? Thank you. It also says in Genesis 2, "Then the Lord said, it is not good that a man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man. And while he was asleep, he took one of the ribs, and then he closed its place up with flesh. And the rib that the Lord took, he said, I'm making this into woman, and brought her to man. Then the man said, this at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." And in Ruth it says, "Entreat me not to leave you or to turn back from following you. For wherever you go, I will go, and wherever you lodge, I will lodge. For your people shall be my people, and your God my God. Where you die, I shall die, and there I will be buried. For the Lord do so to me, and more also, if anything but death separates you and me." Now, I want to give you the definition of love. Love is patient and kind. Love's not jealous, and it's not boastful. Love does not rejoice in wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. Isn't that comforting? Learning to love each other and to live together in harmony is one of the greatest challenges of marriage. Marriage is not to be entered into lightly, which I don't think you are, and we are to hold to it in high honor at all times. Eric and Laura, I charge you both as you stand in the presence of God and these witnesses to remember the love that you feel today. The trust and the loyalty are the foundation of a happy and enduring marriage. No vows are more sacred than those you're about to make. If these vows are kept unbroken, and as you endeavor to do the will of your Heavenly Father, your lives will always be full of joy and love and will be blessed beyond measure. Now, Eric and Laura, I remind you that marriage is a precious gift, a lifelong commitment, and a challenge to love one another more completely each and every day. I'd like for you to please turn to each other and look in each other's eyes. Eric William Meyer, with this understanding, do you take Laura Ann Richardson to be your wedded wife, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaken all others, and to be faithful only to her so long as you both shall live? Laura Ann Richardson, with this understanding, do you take Eric William Meyer to be your wedded husband, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaken all others, and to be faithful only to him, so long as you both shall live.
I do.
Now, would you get your ring for her, please? A ring is an unending circle, which is a representative of an unending love that you're getting ready to pledge. So as you place it on Laura's finger, please repeat these words after me. Go ahead and place it. Say, this ring, a gift for you,
symbolizes my desire.
That you be my wife. From this day forward, as this ring has no end, neither shall my love for you. And would you get his ring, please? Go ahead and place it on his finger. And as you do, I'd like for you to repeat these words. Say,
this ring,
a gift for you, symbolizes my desire,
that you be my husband,
from this day forward,
as this ring has no end,
neither shall my love for you. Now, would you turn and face me? I'd like for us to pray a prayer of blessing. Dear Heavenly Father, our hearts are filled with great happiness today as Eric and Laura's wedding day. And as we come before you and they pledge their hearts and lives to one another, it's my prayer that you grant them that they would ever be true and loving to one another, living together in such a way to never bring shame or heartbreak into their marriage. Temper their hearts with kindness and understanding. Rid them of all pretense of jealousy. Help them to remember to be each other's sweetheart, helpmate, friend, and guide, so that together they may meet the cares and problems of life more bravely. May you, Lord, bless them and keep them. May you make your face to shine upon them and be gracious to them. May you lift up your countenance upon them and give them peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, I'd like to read just a portion of a poem that I think kind of sums up what true love is stemming from, okay? It's by E.E. Cummings, and it says, I carry your heart with me. It says, here is the deepest secret nobody knows. Here is the root of the root and the bud of the bud and the sky of a tree called life, which grows higher than the soul can hope or the mind can hide. And this is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart. I carry it in my heart. Now, I have a challenge for you. I want you to know, when I got married, there was something that I was told, and it has resonated for 34 very happy years. And it is that for every minute you spend angry, you lose 60 seconds of happiness. I want you to remember that, okay? Because you'll never get it back again. You make a choice. Are you going to choose to be angry or to be happy? And another secret is, never let the sun go down on your wrath. Never say goodnight without saying, I'm sorry, or I forgive you. Very important. In other words, don't go to bed angry or upset. Settle any issues before you kiss goodnight. You sleep better, you have more peace, and the next day you're more in love with each other than when you went to bed the night before. In your journey of life together, remind yourselves often that love that brought you together today is the love that will keep you. Give the highest priority to God first, and then your love for one another. When challenges come, and they do, they will, guarantee, sorry, but it happens. But what you do is you have to focus on what's right, not what's wrong, between you. Focus on what's right. In this way you can ride out the storms, and when the clouds hide the sun in your lives, remember, even if you lose sight for just a moment, the sun is still shining, always there. So, for as much as Eric and Laura, you've pledged your love for one another, and you've vowed your commitment to one another, before God and these witnesses, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Too much, was it? Is that right? But you know what I'd like to do now? I'd like for you to turn and face these witnesses. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to, for the first time, present to you Mr. and Mrs. Eric Meyer. Thank you.